right through that area. There's that one up on the pillar, but there's also the other one that's more towards the mid lane that might see the rest of them, and it looks like they're just out of range of it at the moment. So yeah, quests don't realize they're all here right now. Now they see it, Xantic. Obi, thinking about walking in.
The battle begins.
And yeah, they're just gonna let him have it. Two apiece.
Do you think the new collector's cash will empower him here? As yeah, see, we got the same brain, the observer and I. We are one here.
It is kind of cool. Oh my god, dude. What does that look like? It looks like a Dr. Robotnik like beast.
Yeah, this is the leak. Sonic's coming, guys. Our next
Sonic's
hero.
Coming to Dota.
It's not actually Bird Samurai, like you okay. Like we're theorizing.
Okay.
Yeah. It's Bird Sonic. It's going to be very good. I think Xantic can run this game. I think he is the person for Luna Galaxy that can make this happen. Because he basically just has to do the exact same thing that Noob did. Just play like Noob, right? I mean, we've heard that before. Just copy your opponents to great success. That's going to be the plan here. Because there's going to be difficulties in this game that Quest didn't have in the previous match. You can't control lanes the same way with Gyro Io as you can with a Naga Siren, right? You can be a bit more aggressive early with relocates. That's true. But you can't just be 0-0-0 at 30 minutes. It's not going to work the same way. It's not going to give as much to Toby in terms of like the ease of just sitting in this one spot on the map. He'll probably have to be a little bit more active. And I'm hoping that Xantic's going to take a faster speed in this game than Nubis, right? You want to try and ensure that you take advantage of the fact that this Earthshaker wants that Blink Dagger before he does a whole lot on the map.
Yeah, shut things down as much as you can and try and make that map feel small against him. Absolutely. I don't know if I've heard a ton of people saying, you know, just play like Noob, more like you play like Noob is, you know, the other thing.
No, I can play like Noob all the time. Okay. I say that constantly whenever I'm playing any game, really.
Dubai? Oh, buddy. He's living. Never in doubt.
Easy survival there. But the Fly Cannons come immediately back out, and you regret playing against Gyrocopter very quickly.
God, dude, this lane is just, it's really not fun. God, you just get bullied like crazy, man.
Yeah, he's going to bring out some more tangos here. Dilkor even buying some more to try and pass over, try and get him to this ring of health.
Bye? Divide? Oh, God. 30 HP.
Less power armor, honestly.
Yeah, regen. You need every little bit of it that you can get. Bottom Shad has had an okay time, at least. But Toby also off to a hot start. And man, the real problem is that Xantic has not really been able to get as much as he would want. 9 denies on the Earthshaker. There's a reason the Shaker gets picked a decent amount.
Yeah, he really shuts down those other melee heroes. Speaking of heroes that are having a hard time being counterpicked, right? Gyro and Shaker kind of in the same boat here. Just surprisingly effective. We've had some great offlane games and in the mid too. Sometimes having a bad one when he's picked really early, but came up pretty late and there was a very specific thing that they needed on Luna Galaxy's lineup. And you know, you think about heroes that can be that same rotator as a ranged hero, there's not many.
Has been killed.
Shad.
Going. Chasing. Omar gets away. Toby too. Does have a stun back up again soon, but not the mana to cast it for Shad. As couriers are being brought down, Dilkor making those moves over.
Classic Dilkor.
Oh yeah.
And very good for Mirana players. Didn't even have a ward to do it. You'll often like get some early wards down as Mirana's just for the free courier snipes. But that was also a ring of regen there too, so that passive regen for 2000 won't be here. Not that he really needs it, because he is the one on the aggressive here and not looking like there's much chance of a turnaround here. But in the bottom lane, Toby is level 3, so I'm kind of waiting to see if they can find that play again here too, because that's how they got the kill last time. 2 points in the Cinder Brew. It's a lot of, it doubles from level 1 to level 2.
They're going. Starting to. Toby backs away. Didn't use the Thunderclap. So having a really big mana pool right now actually is an interesting situation to be in. He does have a salve coming out. So after using a lot of that momentum, he can maybe just go back in onto Shad again as Divai Llama is still hurting up top. But yeah, they might go on Shad here in a moment with Toby having that salve to Hina back up.
Canceled by the Wave of Terror at the least, though. So didn't get the full value out of that one.
Oh my god, noob. One on Xantic has another enchant totem. Not going yet for much. Oh, still can beat him down. The enchant totem connection for the kill. He just stood there, couldn't do anything.
He wanted that last hit. He thought it was going to die faster. I think he thought something was going to be swinging. I don't know if it was the fissure that messed him up or what, but that was painful. That is a tough way to die. And now he's got the creeps in the tower too, so he's going to miss out on some extra stuff here.
That is, that's hurt. That's got to hurt.
Oh, that creep's dead too.
Oof.
Yeah. So we got 14 denies and then two creeps just dying in the tower too. Well, he's dead.
Should note also, actually, hold on. Toby going in bottom onto Ducalus, tries to bring him down. And thunderclap and the kill. Nice connection there. We got some insider information when we were waiting for this game to get started from the one and only T-Governor, who is actually on a team. Is the arrow connect? Wait a minute. Do they have enough to kill up TA2000? They do. Nice kill there. He was on a team with both Atzantic and Noob. They were on the same team together. That Divine Llama was also playing in the tournament, their first ever tournament together. And now they're battling off against each other in a spot for TI. Just a little bit of a small world in the Div 2's tier scene.
And T dug a hole for patch notes.
Oh, yeah.
So I think they're all really achieving big things right now.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
We all.
That's a nice hole. I think we can all agree. All right, you weren't tired on that.
That's amazing. That's amazing. Right there.
Noob's level 7 right now, dude.
Yeah.
Noob is like, he can't go in the wave right now with Atlantis. He just sees his Earth Shaker and he's, I'm not farming here. I'll tell you that much. And I need this primal beast. If I'm on Blue Galaxy, he's my motor. You know, and he needs a big oil change because he's sludgy.
That's not good.
He needs some new tire fluid. He needs some new light fluid, you know? All the things the mechanic tells me I need.
Transmission? There you go.
No, that's real.
Okay, got it.
Yeah.
Oh, you were saying fake ones, I see.
Yeah.
I thought light fluid was a thing.
All right, you should not take the card, by the way.
Dire's middle All right,
well, in the
attack.
Meantime, it is going to be Quest picking up the Wisdom Rune for Toby. The other one's still sitting there for the moment. I don't think that Quest are going to be able to get over to come and get it. And instead, just for now, it's a rotation over from Theliocor. Going to try and get active down bottom, try and get Luna Galaxy on the map here. Stun, follow-up stun, arrow connects. Don't have the damage. They don't have it. And now Noob shows up, just echoes the old walk-in echo connection. Pretty devastating. And Xantic shows up, tries to take down Toby. It is going to be enough for the finish, not level 6 yet. So they get something at least in return, but losing the Sven there hurts.
He needed that so bad in Xantic, though. They have to get him back into this game desperately right now, because he has to be going around to make these plays on the map, and it's going to be more difficult for Luna Galaxy than it was for Quest last game, because last game it was just simply click pulverize and the hero will die. Ancient Seal, Mystic Flare, Ice Blast, they're going to go down. This time it's not quite as simple. It's going to be more delayed when you're combining things like the arrow afterwards. You're going to need that damage from the trample there too for the Primal Beast, so there will be time for rotations, which could be a problem. There's level 6 on the IO here. Toby still not 6 as he's bullying Shad towards his tower, but this just means that if he's low on HP when he hits 6, it's going to be a bad time.
Right. No, totally. I think one of the other problems too there, as you see, is like starting to put for Theliocor more points into the Star Storm as opposed to the arrow means that when he does connect onto those, it's not doing quite as much as you might anticipate sometimes seeing that combination do. But yeah, it's a tough one. We'll see. Shad again gets gone on a bit here as Toby, but now with Split, they can't really threaten him anymore. God, and Noob just still sits in the creep wave, and Atzantic just has to look at him.
He almost has Blink, man. I feel like one of the best ways they had hope in this game was trying to slow down Noob, but him being in a melee versus melee matchup and getting their early advantage, plus no rotations coming in because of the pressure onto the side lanes, has put them in a very tough spot.
Move in by Llama. Turns to fight TA2000, but Noob is there. Xantic able to get the control for a moment, but they don't have the damage. They really do not have nearly enough. He's trying to get away, and looks like he is going to get some separation. So It's only two going down, but Theodore also, I mean, he might be dead here also, but trapped the echo as he's walking by Nuba. Thought maybe he could get the range there, but that gets him his blink dagger. I don't even know if he saw Theodore actually.
Yeah, I think he did. But yeah, he might not. But he's like, oh, that's a fat stack. Thanks. Thanks, team.
He'll drive by. Hollis throws out the stun, gets the bottle refilled too, onto its Xantic. It is going to be a haste rune down bottom. That is Radiant's a gift, but Noob, he's going to get there first. He breaks it. Oh, man.
That was one thing that Lingassi actually did very well in game one, is they controlled all the runes for the first, I think, I want to say 14 minutes. They got every single rune onto their Earth Spirit. They weren't able to cross over there, and I was kind of hoping maybe they could do the same thing again here at Xantic, but they can't find it here. Now, Noob, now they don't know there's no Echo, right? Oh, actually, he probably saw it on the Marana.
So Xantic gives the little tip back as they manage to get that important kill. Now, he did have the blink dagger already done, but nonetheless, you need these kills on Xantic. He just has phase right now.
It went to the venge, but that's okay.
Yeah.
I'll take it. Dyer's would have been nice on Xantic because he's going to need his BKB really badly to play this game.
Oh, yeah. I mean, anytime you can kill the top net worth hero, it's really important, but need to try and find TA 2000. They have a very good save hero at the ready as stacks are being built up. Io is online with his level 6 now.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And Ducalus gonna get found. Noob, easy bring down.
Like to see some deep vision here as well from Quest to keep this up.
Noob has played a phenomenal series. MVP game number one, and if I had to choose my MVP right now, it would be him again.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, this is just how you win the game. Like, no one else even has to do anything. And this game is already looking so firmly in their control. And Xantic's doing a great job of catching back up, though. Like, he's not as far behind, honestly, as I would have expected. He's only 1,200 gold behind at almost 12 minutes, but it was that rough of a start. Noob, though, he's just ready to go and slay. Like, I imagine him and Omar are going to smoke up in a second after this wave clear and just go. Just try and find somebody. Stacks are being built up here, though, for Shad. They got to protect these, though. Might want to take them sooner rather than later. But he doesn't want to give up this bottom tower for free.
Right. Yeah, I mean, that's the weird situation that they're kind of in. Toby even just denying two creeps in his face anything they can to try and slow them down. There is going to be a window here, right? BKBs queued up and
this
coming
is good.
Out soon.
They're coming through the twin gate. They're trying to gank onto Shad, but they're rotating to the jungle at the same time. They might break this up.
And they already get the split off, though. And now moving over with the Xantic. It's going to be too late. Shad is so close. Almost dead, but the swap away keeps him alive. Doing good damage, but they get the relocate out.
Radiant's middle
Are they
tower
only going to get the IO out of this? Wow. That's crazy. Really nicely played by Quest to get everybody else out of harm's way. Hey, come back. 2,000's here. Toby moves back in. Okay. Ducalus is going to just die. So nobody dies on the side of Quest. For more, Ilkor escaping. Gets one leap charge off. Omar still chasing here. Only one point in the arcane bolt, so it's not going to do that much damage. But if he can get the concussive shot, which it looks like he will, killing spree.
Spree nice and early here, huh? 3-0 and 2. Another great start here from Omar. And although it was a great defense play to keep Shad up, it was a little bit better there from Quest to fully commit and bring down Noob, the big boss. But at least get Shad out alive and farming that top stack. He takes down the Ancients, he takes down the Hurricane. He's now top of the board because of that save from his team. He's gonna try not to give up too much else here as Noob moves in. They have Mystic Lair in 20. They even need it.
They're just gonna jump right away onto Xantic. That long duration and silence. Divine Llama shows up. Echo connection. Fissure onto two. Noob trying to back away, and he will manage to escape. Well, Divine Llama, not sure if he's gonna be so lucky. They're trying to get way through. Get out of there. But the jump in. Noob finds a boat, breaks the move through the portal. Just an immaculate performance from this Earthshaker.
That's too good, man. The tips are very well deserved here. It's 3-12. A 3K lead right now, and that 3K is pretty much the gap between the mids, the mid diff. It is humongous right now. He's just finding it all. The early blink. It's going to be a pretty early Aghanim's on top of that here. You can't ask for anything more from Noob in this game.
Absolutely killing it. And maybe playing things a little bit greedy, not going right back to Fountain yet, but he doesn't feel like he's worried about a thing. Going to farm up the rest of that stack and then head on back himself. Unreal. Is he really going to lane right now? Dude, this guy's crazy. This is confidence right here. This is an insane level of confidence. Like, they have Fiend's Gate.
He's got wards. He sees them, right? I mean, that might tip them off. They're like, this is a nasty vision if this guy's going to go mid like that.
Yeah. That's nuts. Like, he's so much of a, like, the gold lead. The fact that he just walks into that lane like that, it shows how confident they're playing right now.
Radiant.
We gotta find some new solutions here from Luna. It's not as bad as the position of the last game, that's for sure. And also the fact that Shad is still getting that farm on is huge for them. Noob gonna jump right back out onto Shad, but it's not a cure they can really just combo down all by himself. But they don't have that assassination power that we saw from Quest last game. They don't have the stun into immediate blow up from the AA and the kick of Scarab Nade. We got Vengeance and Morana, who are a little bit more versatile, right? We got some save potential here. We got long range change stun from the arrow. We got Moonlight Shadow giving us some mini smokes throughout the game, but there's been amazing vision by Quest throughout the series. Also, all the sentry combos I've noticed. Now there's just more of them. It's like right now, walking right through that on the Morana.
Yeah, I mean, they're there. And TA2000 just throws out a missile and heads back towards farming. You know, you're right, though. It doesn't feel as, like, sort of crushingly hopeless for Luna Galaxy as it did last game, but I'm not sure if much
of top. Can they get him? Oh, they got him. They cancel his blank, swap back.
Echo dropping, but the turn, it's there. Oh, my God, Ducalus.
How do you steal that?
Ducalus, sir.
He's too good. He's too strong.
We gotta talk. The
tree block
about that. Terry, it wouldn't have mattered, but still, that is the type of kill that they need. That
Dire's top tower.
That was crazy.
How? How does that happen again? It looks like that last punch did so much damage. It was 113, just having me directly after the spend did 500. Okay, gotcha.
Venge is strong.
Yep.
Universal heroes.
I mean, she has 5 deaths, so she is vengeful right now.
It's true.
More and more powerful.
Well, that was big. Those types of kills, if you can find Shad and take him out, and particularly playing around these BKB timings, right? You've almost got it completed on the Sven. You Dyer's almost have it done on Primal. They're really going to be able to mess these heroes up. The key, I feel like, is going to be down to Kaori being there for the saves when, you know, people get gone on.
That, and in terms of how are you going to play these initiations? Because Toby's game last time was much easier on the Brewmaster. That's one thing I like about putting Primal Beast and Brewmaster on the same team, is that you're going to have this Primal Beast onslaughting in and creating a lot more openings for your Brewmaster to decide when to split, how to split, and what the fight's going to look like. But you have Shaker now, who doesn't tend to go in first. If anything, you're kind of hoping the Brew goes in first to clump a fight and provide good stuff for the Shaker. Unless you have like a dream setup, obviously, then Shaker can just do his dunk thing. But you kind of have both somewhat counter-initiators here with the Brew and the Shaker, so it's not as clear. And then they also don't have like a ranged four, or sorry, like a melee four that goes in, like your Tusks, your Earth Spirits, your Spirit Breakers. So the fight buildup isn't as easy for Quest as the previous game. And that could hurt Toby's game overall.
I mean, that's probably why we see it all the time now anyways, but that's probably a big part of the reason why Noob is willing to rush this Aghanim's after the blink too. Because then you can play maybe a bit more of that, like go in there, make some magic happen without dropping the Echo and jumping out of the fight.
That's when it like all comes together.
Oh, Theodore. He's gonna survive that, actually. And now a move in. Moonlight Shadow. They're around the area, but not gonna go for the full commitment yet. Divine Llama standing in a creep wave. He has Pipe, he has a Healing Lotus. Does he want to stick around long enough? The tower is dead. He can still jump, but the swap is gonna be there. Shadow looks for the turn. They're onto him. He pops the ulti, he did pop. Oh my god! Explodes one, but the turnaround is gonna be there. Sven starting to lay into them. Does he have enough to take down Noob? No, he can't control him. The Aghanim Scepter, too strong. It was a buyback also from Ducalus.
I think Shad thought they swapped in, not the beast. I think he thought they were bringing in an enemy, and that's why he popped his ulti like that. Because it looked like he was ready to just go on that swapped target, right. not go up the Radiant's hill after. It still almost worked out after with the stun and the immediate damage afterwards, but he said not quite enough control to get through it. You can see the possibilities though. Like those Broodlings start getting pretty low. The Shaker gets dunked on pretty fast. I mean, he still only has 8 armor because you are a strength hero. But fortunately, there's not a whole lot of minus armor when you blow up the Colossus. So just don't get hit by that.
Mid lane, Nuke immediately onto the Vi'Lama, connects for the kill. This is starting to come undone a little bit here. Theliocor in trouble. Arcane Bolt going to connect, but he should be able to survive through that one.
As he does eventually get off the back of it.
Radiant's middle tower.
Yeah, it's really starting to come together for Quest. They're on the verge here.
It's a little scary to move further into the Radiant territory if you're not all grouped up, especially if you don't have to relocate, but that's back up in a few seconds. So they're gonna take the safe route here and just move back over to their own side. Wait till things like Echo Slam are back up when they're really powerful, because they're at the point now where they should just be thinking about the Aegis. They're at that point where they can easily go and take it, and likewise, so can the Galaxy, especially this Wave of Terror. They see Shad in a vulnerable state, but there's no way.
He did just relocate, so they got both wisdom runes. But the jump, another god strength, and no chance for a connection there. Oh, that hurts. Not able to do it. Wanted a swap play, I think, again. They're gonna go in and maybe try and hunt under Moonlight Shadow, but they're all running away on Quest. And now he has a blink dagger on Shad. That's gonna make things easier. It's still not easy, though.
Yeah, definitely is not. It's going to be back to advantage again. Yeah, he still has an 8-second BKB. We do have the counter pipe up here for Toby, though, so I'll be able to pop that off before these engagements start. We got a Spirit Vessel, though, for that Gyrocopter. That's pretty huge. Catch him out the BKB and try and mitigate a little bit of this Vampire Fangs. Doesn't go Satanic next. He wants Silver Edge first.
Oh, interesting. Oh, okay. I guess
yeah,
for the
pretty
Underlord.
Good this game. Underlord, you know, Sven, lots of decent reasons. Even Venge, you know, doesn't hurt.
Right, totally.
Of course, you know, you only hit one person. Usually you're not Silver Edging into Avenge.
Right.
One would imagine.
Well, 4 to 15, a 6,000 gold lead, and the Quest, generation. Today at the very least, have looked immaculate in their games that we've been seeing. Obviously did get pushed to the full 3 games when they were playing against Secret earlier, but right now on the verge of a 2-0 to get their way into TI. Let's see if they can do it, though.
Link up, Courier flying through. They don't have vision of it, though, so it's not going to tip them off to anything.
They're very split. They are very split right now.
Oh, this would be so huge. They have detection. If they,
it's
they
antic.
Have no
They're
detection.
Right at the area. They see the ward. They see it drop down. The jump forward. They find the IO. Shad on him. TA2000 invis, they would have, did they not see the tether? Oh my god, dude, that's Silver Edge. He just walked away. Oh, that could have been so much bigger for them. But maybe they can get Roche.
So insane, just like the no detection.
Oh god, and now they're gonna walk back in. Is Noob gonna do it all to them? They have gotta be careful. Roche down to half HP, Toby walking up front and center. They see him, they're backing away. They're not going to get the Roche. And they don't have God Strength anymore.
Is under attack.
They're all on a ward.
I respect them for leaving, honestly.
Yeah.
Radiant's top
been a lot worse.
Under attack.
I mean, this is on the edge. If you lose this fight tragically, that's your TI hopes almost over right now if you're a Lunate Galaxy. There's still a chance, though, that they can pull this back with a good fight here. So it has to be perfect.
Yeah, Quest a little more to play with being up one game, but they still understand that this is a pretty solid opportunity they're sitting on right now, and it's Xantic just nervously pacing back and forth here. Wonder what the hell am I supposed to do on this hero right now. Can't give it up. I have to stay nearby. If I get jumped on right now, what happens to me? Probably just lose the fight. You really have buy it back.
Vivax in this situation too, that much more important because they have the Underlord. He can reach very rapidly.
Gyro's in.
Walks up.
Stakes.
He's on high ground.
Oh, they run.
He saw them all. They ran away. Okay, Pitamal is down. Swap in. Finds that kill. That's big. Roach very low. Now running for more. The catch. The buyback. Brewmaster's trying to get back into this fight.
They're waiting.
Take him a little bit to walk here. They're waiting for him. You got to take advantage of this one. You've already used a lot.
Undrink
now down. If they're not careful, they're not going to be able to take it. Oh, but Roshi comes through. Oh my gosh, Luna Galaxy. They're in a decent position now. Quest going to run forward. If they control this area, they're in trouble. They find him. Oh, Divine Llama. They're onto him. He's silenced. He's dead. And Zantik tries to run away. They're going to find Ucalus as well. And that is going to give Quest Roche. They knew with God Strength down, they could run it.
Yeah. It's too tough. They tried to make a bit of a call out there, I think, where they're hoping to relocate with maybe get burnt or something. I'm not sure. They didn't have the solid plans, and they couldn't find their moment where they felt like they could go in. It probably had to be immediately after the Brewmaster died to get a good sense of it, but I mean, they're still a tier 1 tower. Like, he's gonna be back so soon. Very easy from our point of view to be like, oh, they're kind of vulnerable here. But right. Even with the good vision they laid out trying to prepare themselves for a fight in this area, they couldn't find it, and the timings of the God's Strength comes back to hurt them.
Noob jumps in, Echo's there, and Zantik now to half HP. They turn, Chat finds one, finds another, onto him, trying to take him down. Zantik doesn't get the stun off, though. In the meantime, Noob is just laying waste to the rest of the squad to move in. Chat trying to do what damage he can, but now has to run away. The oh my god, Noob, you monster! You monster! Stop doing it to him! It's dirty!
He's too good. He's actually just too good this game. Really well done. I mean, you just can't ask any more of this guy this series. Absolutely owning that. The call out there to just jump and dunk onto the Underlord, right? Because he just wants to start a fight. We have Aegis Gyrocopter. I just want to fight right now. And you can see the power that Chad has when he gets right in there and he starts putting the hurt into the Gyrocopter, but then the control comes back out from Noob. Didn't BKB very early in that fight because, you know, he's been feeling the timings. So thinking like, I can't God Strength too early. I can't BKB too early. All the windows are so short for myself right now. And I just don't have that playmaker getting in there for me. They haven't been able to find that. Like, Zantik has not been able to get a game going with this Primal Beast.
I mean, it has not been able to, since the very beginning, it's just been all new. And you know, you're laying out, like we've talked about, this sort of red carpet for TA2000 to get incredibly farmed and just beat into these heroes. And it's not stopping, you know, with Aghanim Scepter done and Aegis for another 3 minutes, they're going to pressure bottom tier 2 tower. My goodness.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
My goodness.
Yeah, grab a couple of tier 3 tokens here. See if we can find some bigger items. I already saw Noob got the Ogre Seal Totem, so in case he gets locked down, he'll be getting out of there, but the fine one as well for Divine Llama. Keeps that top wave pushing out as Gyro ascends to the high ground. Swap still just level 1 here. So shorter cast range and with a Aegis and a potential relocate save, it's kind of hard to do any big swap plays. They're going to try to swap into immediate pulverize by the looks of it.
In range, they get him now. Noob, they jump in. Shad finds the stun on the 2, trying to take him down, but there it is. That Ogre Seal Totem that you talked about in TA 2000, not dealt with, not killed. They're trying to chase down the rest of them, but Shad ran out of his BKB. He is going to fall. They might go for more. They have creeps coming in a moment, but 60 seconds without the spin. Quest are going to take this set of racks.
Chill.
Divine Llama missile going out. Connected. Toby, he wants to go back to TI. They're going to connect. They are taking Rax down. But Quest feeling themselves at the moment, and the call is to go on.
All right, relax.
We've seen this before. Teams, they get a sense, a moment where maybe TI is in their grasp, and they're just going to go for it. Another glyph used. TA 2000, he doesn't want to go home. Is this the throw? Is this the play that ends up sending them back, or are they going to be able to punch their ticket to Seattle? They are right on the verge.
They're doing it for the fans. They've seen the game timings. They heard your cries.
They want to end it right now. Quest going for the all-in play. End of this game. They're back up soon. They're backing away.
They have Echo back.
Guys, the throne is exposed. It takes so much tenacity, but they can get down the jump in. Nobody finds a phone. Two are gone. Can they take them all the way down? And Zantik is out, but they
wait, Chad.
Murata. Chad starting to lay into these heroes. He wants to turn on to Noob. Noob has the jump away, ready with that enchant totem to back out. Throne is exposed, but they went in very far. If they get TA 2000 now, this would be huge. They find Omar. Chad, he gets the third. Noob, he's looking for the turn. The Fisher is going to be there. TA 2000 pops BKB. Kaori buys back into this one. Chad turns, kills him. Ultra kill. Can they find more? The stun. They get him. They're on to TA 2000. It's been good so far, but 15 seconds left on the Aegis. TA 2000, the stun. The Aegis is expiring soon. Noob is off to the side. They went in so far, and now they're getting punished. Noob onto Atlantic. They get that kill. TA 2000 still in trouble.
Where's the stun?
Aegis is gone. Noob is starting to die. Shad got him. That's a delayed rampage. They find another buyback. They are crumbling on Quest. As just like that, they find a sign of life.
Why is he buying back?
Dude, the pressure is real. They want a TI so bad. Look at the swing.
Is that a 15,840? Is that 6,000 experience?
Oh my God. Dude, how many times have we seen teams one game away from TI put themselves in that situation? They went for the tier 4 towers. There's still a tier 1 top. Oh my God.
My respect for that has just grown.
Oh no, Trent. Oh, okay. when you can feel it coming, you know you're at your moment. That's when it can slip through your grasp.
Use the might.
All right, but is it still out of reach? Okay, is it? Maybe it's okay. They're still pretty strong, right?
I mean, they were up 15K. They still had Aegis. Look at how much was given away. 30 minutes, 15K gold lead.
It is insane. I can't believe the kills just kept stacking up too.
And it almost like it was so close to maybe going back. We're like, oh, this is it though. T2000 turns it back on. Kaori buys back and the noob's lurking in the side. Then
they just get worked again.
What a defense here. What a crazy play to try and go for the throne. And yes, it is exposed. That is huge, but there's still a lot of defense in that middle, in that top lane. Question now, we basically just moved into a like, oh, this game is kind of easy for us now, to a just make sure we get the next Roche. We're probably still fine.
Cool.
Oh, look at this. It's done before the butterfly.
Yeah. No. They're, I mean, that's one thing for sure. I agree with you that like they still have a good window, but we also have to consider those buybacks. There's no buyback on the Io or the Earthshaker. If Earthshaker dies right now, this entire game is flipped on its head.
That's so insane that he just bought MKB and Gyro just finished Butterfly. That is crazy.
They basically gave him MKB with that fight. Like that Ulver kill into, I think, another double after.
And Dota,
I can't believe he got
momentum
move in the end too.
Dota, a momentum game.
They're lurking. They're waiting.
They're walking in. TA 2000. He heads out, but they're Murana ulti.
Do they have detection? They don't have detection.
It doesn't quite look like it's swapping to let him hit harder. Shan, he did it again.
Oh, he flicked out. The missile.
Unbelievable. Can he survive through it, though? Get that bounty rune. That will save you, surely. He lives.
He drops down to double-digit HP. And it's still fighting right now as Divine Llama's getting pretty low. Carries back in the fight. Oh, I think Atlantic's down.
No, you know, he's not going to do it. They end up losing 4. Okay, it's a dieback for Shaker, but they won the fight on the back end of it. I don't know how. I don't know what the hell is happening Radiant's in this game.
All I know is that Omar did mad work. He almost hit 5k damage on a Skywrath Mage.
That's insane.
And this guy has a Psychic Headband and an Atos. So shout outs, insane shout outs there. Must have been the Shield of Sion. It's all in the shard.
Dude, what the hell? What the hell? I can't believe it.
They got nothing out of Shaker. He just went down. Like, that's a fight with no noob, who has been one of the most stalwart forces they've had this whole game. You look at the net worth chat right now. It's Gyro, and then it's a lot of Luna Gaming heroes at this point. Like, Luna Galaxy, the gamers of the Luna. And the Roche, by the way, a very long spawn. We were close to maxing out on that one here. So that has just meant that whole fight was just a little bit of a preview. It was nothing but an appetizer, because everything's going to be back up by the time we have the real battle here in a minute.
Well, the things that still won't be back up, I believe, are a couple more of those clutch buybacks. I can't believe they didn't get Io. I thought he was dead for sure. Oh, this game has completely taken on a new life. You're almost at level 20s on the Underlord and on the Primal Beast. Underlord about to hit it here. Oh, man.
Look at this loop they're going. They're going for a humongous wraparound all the way around from where that courier is flying right now from Brewmaster, who just got a Lotus Orb. Might save him. Let him get his fight off. Chad has to be careful. He doesn't BKB first, and he stuns himself. Look at this wrap. Arrow for the scouting.
They now know that they're coming in from that angle. TH2000 walks high ground, gets the BKB off in time, rolls through and walls to find.
They're on the Brew.
There. Echo, Chad, he didn't get it off in time. Now has to walk around the fissure. Can he take down TH2000? It's not easy. They have to run away. Luna have to run away. They're losing him. Chad is gone. Just like that, it turns on its head. Oh,
split
man.
As well. Dukalos is just going to get mopped up here by Toby. Toby just cancels the split for a bit, waits for the BKBs. Oh, Divine Llama. No stun. He's going to jump out of that one. Actually went to the mid lane if they noticed that. It could follow. In the back line there, Fieldcore trying to do some sneaky plays here.
He's just going to get brought down too. All right, just like that, Quester back. I mean, it's been a crazy couple of minutes, but they are now back in firm control of this game. And with an Aegis and Cheese in hand, this is going to be the safe window that I'm anticipating we see some slow pushing coming out from Quest now.
Reevaluate the battle plans a little bit here this time, you know. Noob also going in towards an Aeon Disc. Does not want to find himself in another one of these situations where he's only getting one chance and being blown up. Not getting to actually play his hero. Invis room popped here. They've been getting annihilated by the Invis. Not a lot of protection laid down. As I say that though, Dukal's going to get a sentry down. Maybe going to catch Noob if he gets really greedy coming high ground here. Cool. Noob. Points it.
Dude, this guy's crazy. He still has that buyback.
Swap out. Nice.
Swap out. Still in trouble. Check it out. 1, 2, 3. Takes him down. Can they get more? He now into this gyro. Gyro's gone. Toby doesn't have anything, doesn't have ulti. They went in again and lose the Aegis. They don't have the Io.
TH2000
starting to fall. Shaq is a monster. They get him again, and TH2000 starts to go down. He's gone.
You've got
to
be kidding me.
Shaq is a monster unleashed. Divine Llama drops the gate down, wants to fight, just barely out of range of Omar. As Toby still trying to escape, but Xantic is on him. They run through, find him with that pulverize. I thought for sure they were just gonna slowly, steadily do it, but Quest, they keep wanting to throw. What is happening?
They got one gear, you know, they're just in drive, maybe. There's no reverse. There's no slow. This isn't a transition.
A train?
Manual, that's the one. Oh, a train. Yeah. It's a train.
Train, no backwards, only forwards.
It's a train transmission. That's what we're going with here. They got some problems.
Dire's
Jeez, dude.
I kind of still feel like it's fine. I feel like Omar is doing everything you could possibly ask of a support right now. I can't believe he escapes there. He holds on to the gem. He's doing so much damage in these fights and trying to get as much control as he can, but the BKB is obviously making it pretty hard for a Skywrath Mage. Now they're going high ground. Will they meet the same fate? Are they going to go a little bit too hard when they don't have this big lead?
It's only the one lane that they can take, so you never know. Maybe they're like, hey, only tier 4 towers left to hit.
Dire structures are fortified.
These teams in this grand finals are starting to put together some crazy stuff. Bucolus there for the save, and Xantic is nearby with Gyrocopter coming back to life. Everybody else is just going to get out. My God,
well,
man.
Not everybody.
Okay. Bye, Bucolus. Nuke's still hunting. Chasing, forced to use a leap. I can't believe what Noob has been doing.
You know, he saw his moment, he thought. Didn't end up quite being there for them. But now they're back. Quest, same situation this time. What do we have? We got Bruce Blitz. All right. We got BKBs, we got Satanic. No God Strength for another 15 seconds. Just do it again. That's the plan right now.
See, this is why everybody out there is like, no, don't just, why is everybody, nobody going high ground? This is why. This game right here is why you never go high ground. Ever. Cool.
It is an unfortunate realization that people usually have in competitive games. Across every competitive game is that, you know what, guys? Camping's usually better. Just a thought. Just playing defensive, oftentimes, kind of optimal. It's painful, but it's often the truth.
Oh, geez, man. This one is getting down to the wire.
Radiant are scanning.
The scary thing as we've seen is that all it takes is like one bad positioning mistake by Quest, and Shad will run them down. Also, he has more room to grow. Right now, he's got the Echo Saber. I would love to see him pick up a harpoon.
Yeah, I mean, he's doing so well getting on top of the IO anyway. But true. It feels like Carrie's trying to hide, and that little bit of extra mobility would be a great reason for it. They might also want to try and get a Nullifier because there's going to be a lot of Aeon Discs coming up in this game, right? Probably Brew eventually if we keep going. Earthshaker is still looking at one but didn't commit for it.
Right. Yeah, I mean, there's so much that you need at this stage. But Shad has become the monster. Even though TA 2000 is, 5,000 gold ahead of him, it just feels really tough to stand toe-to-toe because, you know, a big chunk of that gold is the butterfly, which isn't doing things when he's hitting with an MKB. Oh, jeez. All right, we've settled down a bit, Trent.
They've seen what's happening here. It's been a bit much going high ground right now. They want to try and catch them out on the map where they have a bit more advantage there and things aren't so easy for them because Dukalis is just getting way too much of these swaps up on the high ground. He's saving people from behind the fissures. It's nice and easy for him. You want to make things a little bit more complicated because remember, he doesn't actually have any mobility. He has drums, but there's no blink, right? There's no force staff or anything like that. So if it's not in such a sedentary place, like up on the high ground, he's going to have a hard time getting those sweet swaps. Has to play pretty tight. Divine Llama as well. The Halberd came in at a pretty clutch time. It's been doing some work here in these fights as they make their way down by the Twin Gate. Still got a long road till that next Aegis. And I'm not sure what the torrential timings are. Oh, there they go.
Are they going for the throne? Dude, our quest it is exposed and there is a creep wave. Oh my god.
No, they have glyph. They have glyph.
They're in the base. Dude, T2000. Oh my god, jump in, no, you never expect the echo right next to your ancient. What in the hell? They're in so deep. They drop down the Pit of Malice, realizing we need to get here for this fight, but he's already gone. What a gank.
Hey guys, the Ancient's just right there. You could just start hitting it, it'd be fine.
Surely nothing bad would happen.
Now this I like. Do not go Ancient, just get your kill.
Jump in.
Take a little prize.
Shad wanting to find the target, but he's controlled by Noob. Divine Llama comes back into this one. God Strength already popped. The control is there. Great lift up by Toby. Nicely done on that primal. And Shad, I mean, he's getting pulled every which way. He's not able to do anything. TA2000 takes down Divine Llama. That's a dieback. Now the stage is set. The time is now.
New
turn. They find him. Noob, he was in again. They catch him and they kill him. But Quest, they are starting to hit the throne. There is still a glyph available. Oh my god, Quest, they go for all of it again. They want to just end this game. Get me out. But
where's
still
the BKB?
Come back to haunt them. Shad, he's hanging on to that BKB. God Strength back up in 10 seconds. Can they afford to wait that long, though? If
Xantic rolls through them all. Ancient having
control.
Still moving in, trying to take it down. God Strength 4 seconds away. They need that damage. They need it now. Control Shad is there. He has the Satanic turning, stunning, starting to beat into him. Does he have the damage? No, the Satanic from Tier 2000 is too big. Luna is going to go down. They just need to hit the throne a couple more times. Quest is going to TI.